Hey everyone, Stefan here, live from the Galaxy event where Samsung just announced the Galaxy XR available on shelves today. The Galaxy XR is a powerful device that allows users to play and work in completely new ways by seamlessly blending the digital and physical world. This launch is an exciting moment because the Samsung Galaxy XR is the first device to be available on the Android XR platform. So what does that mean to you as a developer? With Android XR, you can take advantage of the same familiar tools like Android Studio and Jetpack Compose. Use your same code base and extend it with additional APIs and capabilities. And as you're developing for headsets and Android XR, you're also setting yourself up for the future for glasses. So, how do you get started? First is developing adaptive for Android. When you do this, you build a UI that will naturally work on this new headset in home space. Users will be able to resize it and interact with your components in a seamless way. Step two is really differentiating your app so it shines on XR. You do this by using features such as environments, spatial UI, and 3D objects using the Jetpack XR SDK. This is an opportunity not just to optimize, but to create differentiated experiences only available on Android XR. We recently sat down with the team at Calm to understand how they did this. Kristen and Jamie, thanks for joining us. Can you start by telling us a little bit about what Calm is and the company's mission?
Calm is a leading mental health and wellness company dedicated to helping users sleep better, stress less, and live more mindfully. We're always exploring new ways for users to connect more deeply with our content to accomplish this.
That focus on ways for users to engage with your content makes your jump into XR exciting. What was the vision for the Calm experience on Android XR?
So we were really excited that Android XR allowed us to create a version of Calm that couldn't exist anywhere else. And building for Android XR allowed us to craft a serene and emotionally intelligent sanctuary that users wouldn't just want to visit, but really return to.
For developers who might think building for XR is a massive undertaking, what was your initial approach to bringing your existing 2D app over?
Our main goal was to adapt our Android app for XR. And honestly, the process was really easy. We already used Jetpack Compose extensively, so expanding that expertise into XR was a natural choice for us. We were building our first Orbiter menus on day one and had a core XR Calm experience in about 2 weeks.
Could you tell us about what you built to translate the Calm experience into this new spatial environment?
Two key areas that we really love from our mobile app are the breathe bubble and our scenes. So we reimagined those. What would those be like in an XR world? The breathe bubble is our beloved breathwork experience, but brought into 3D. It's this soft pulsing orb that really anchors users to their breath, but now with a full environmental immersion. In the Calm mobile app, we have scenes. These are customizable backgrounds that the users can select. So now with our Calm XR app, you can select scenes, but they completely wrap around you for a fully immersive environment.
What were the keys to building a visually compelling experience that feels native to the Android XR platform?
So I think the immersive canvas really allowed us to rethink how users engage with mindfulness content. So not just listening or watching, but really inhabiting. The interface gently encourages exploration, so it offers users agency while maintaining a clear, emotionally attuned path. We started with concept art, so that helped us establish our direction, which we then translated into 3D models using a human-scale reference to ensure natural proportions. Whenever possible, we tested the assets directly into a headset to fine-tune scale, lighting, and atmosphere.
Do you have any advice for other developers that are looking to build immersive XR experiences?
My advice is to think as big as possible. I think that teams should ask themselves, what is the biggest, boldest version of your experience that you could possibly build? Because now you actually have the platform that can make it real.
So my advice to the other developers would be just integrate the Jetpack XR APIs into your existing app and see what happens. The APIs are very consistent with the other Jetpack libraries you're probably used to. Then you can focus your energy on creating new XR specific experiences.
The work you have all done is truly inspiring. Thank you for showing developers what's possible on the Android XR platform. If you're ready to get started, you can find all the resources you need at developer.android.com/XR. Head over there to download the latest SDK, explore our documentation, and start building the next generation of spatial experiences today. We can't wait to see what you create.